Disclaimer, this makes me an expert. Not really. I mean, if anything, it must mean I'm a marketing genius, right?
Hello, Honda Shadow. No, that's a Suzuki Intruder. No, that's a Marauder. Suzuki Marauder. Everyone knows Intruders are better. Godspeed, buddy. Oh.
You guys ever just eat something awful? You knew it was awful the whole time you were eating it? Guys, I just ate a f***ing half a bag of Takis. Took me a couple months to get through it because that shit's just so gross. Oh my god. They market them like they're hot, but they're not. It's just like if you were to reduce 50 lemons down, or limes, down to just a solid sugar coating, and then you just dipped a tortilla chip in it and threw some hot pepper sauce on it just for fun. Well, not even kidding when I say I just swallowed 60 ounces of water to get that down. But hopefully that just means I'm hydrated. It's like 93 degrees right now. Anyways, I was gonna work on the next Samurai update vid. But if you guys follow me on Instagram, you'll see that it might not be doable within a week's time span. So figured I'd go ahead and do a short motovlog. And just to make sure I'm jinxed and it doesn't go, that's going to be the subject of the one that I tried to record on this camera before, and it didn't record sound. So now that I don't need sound on it, let's talk about it. The Indian 4, and why it's not going to happen. Or at least it won't be Indian's next bike. Oh, see that bump? Jeez. So there's a few reasons why it won't be happening. Nice signal. Unironically. Without sarcasm. So, I don't think you really need to be an expert on motorcycling right now to know that motorcycling isn't all that cheap. Especially if you're looking at an Indian. One of the bigger twins, anyway. And if you look at Indian's past, and when they brought out the 4, you can see that initially it was somewhat of a success. It happened kind of right around the time World War II was picking up and then cooling off and all that. But one of the biggest problems was cars were becoming commercially available at the time. So no one really needed to pay somewhat near car prices for a luxury motorcycle when they could have something much more practical. And remember, this is America coming out of the Great Depression, so I'm sure everyone was pinching their pennies. Or so I would think. You know, the economy boomed after World War II. But here's the problem. Motorcycling as it is now is not everyday travel for most people. Like, I need to tell you that. So not only is that sort of marketing attitude the same right now, where you'll see a lot more people buying cars over Indian 4, I think it would be really discrediting to Polaris to assume that they think otherwise. What I'm trying to get at here is entry level is probably, in my opinion, the most important segment to be focusing on right now when it comes to motorcycle marketing. And I think Indian knows that as well. And that's evidenced quite a lot by the constant teasing you see about the FTR 1200 custom. I mean, I know that's a one-off custom build, and I don't even think they're the ones who built it. They could have been, but I've seen a few builds from a few people, like Roland Sands has done something cool too. But I mean, they're damn near marketing that bike without selling it, if you pay attention to their social media posts and whatnot. So they know. They know that they need to focus on entry level. Because, especially when it comes to American motorcycles, the Harley Sportster has always been everyone's go-to starter cruiser. So I think, with the Indian Scout being the competitor to that, I don't know where they're going to price the FTR 1200, but I'm pretty sure it's going to be around the same price as a Scout, if not a little bit less, due to having fewer features, if that makes sense. But, more to the point. Why won't the Indian 4 be the next motorcycle? Well, as I mentioned, entry level being the focus, I think the biggest problem is prohibitive cost to entry. Oh, big bumps. Not too bad. See, they fixed the 2017 Scout suspension pretty well. 2016 was kind of a bad year. What I think I'm really trying to get at is saying, research and development I mean, look, Polaris is like three times the size of Harley, but you know, Indian's only going to see so much of that allotted budget. And I can only imagine that the research and development to create a new inline four, especially if they decide to keep it air-cooled, man, I think that's going to be a big, big money pit. And look, I say this as a person who has really taken a loving to Indian motorcycles, especially the Indian 4. I think the Indian 4 is just a... I mean, who doesn't love that? It's America succeeding in doing what America isn't known for succeeding in, and doing it better than everyone else because no one else was really doing it. And you can make the argument... that that's one of the things that did him in, but I don't think so. I think the Indian 4 was a limited run enough production to where it was a success. And I think that's what Polaris is going to have to focus on, sort of doing that same strategy. I don't think the Indian 4 was a failure in its day. I think the problem nowadays is making it modern. I assume they're going to have to use an aluminum block, just kind of like the Scout is. I think it'll be easier to go aluminum just because cooling will be probably a little bit better. I think they're going to have to liquid cool it. There's just no getting around it. Unless they want a big understressed motor that has less power than the Thunderstroke 111 and Big Bore Kit 116. But I think cooling is actually going to be the biggest problem in the research costs involved because... Oh, thank you for not turning into me. But why do I bring up cooling so much? I think the problem is going to be cooling in that I'm looking at bikes of the same sort of market segment that it would fill. So I'm not really looking at the touring elements of the bike. I'm more sort of just looking at like power and performance and all that sort of thing. And I see the only competitor right now to that being the Triumph Rocket 3. And the Triumph Rocket 3, you know, I've never ridden one, so I can't speak from experience to this, but looking at the people who have, like Shade Tree Surgeon, I think I've seen a few others on YouTube. I mean, they've all made videos talking about just how hot at least the exhaust pipes are. I think trying to keep multiple cylinders in line with the road and not flat against for cooling efficiency is an issue. Now, this is me speaking completely out my ass here, but I want to say those rear cylinders are going to get hotter than the front. So not only do they have to contend with how to heat it, they have to contend with their own Thunderstroke motors, because that's what they're going to be competing against, as well as everybody else in the segment. Think the Goldwing. Although the new Goldwing's not doing as well as the older one, as far as I know. But you look at all that, and then you see, hello. Don't walk in front of me. So you see the power they're going to be looking at, versus they could make a power cruiser like a muscle bike, sort of like the Triumph Rocket 3. Or they could choose to kind of go the old route and make it a big understressed motor made to eat up miles and do it smoothly like an inline four would do. My hat's off to Indian if they can engineer that in a nice costly manner to where it's approachable to most people in that segment. So yeah, what's the long and short of it? Indian 4? Maybe. Indian FTR 1200? That's what's coming out. On staking my bet on the FTR 1200 coming out before anything else. And I actually have talked to someone who said that they went to the plant in Indian where they're made and they saw an experimental frame. This is deep covert info here, but he said he was in the factory, he saw a different looking frame that would not fit a Thunderstroke bike. The guide on the Indian tour of the factory, the guy looked at the guy who worked for Indian, he was like, is that? The Indian worker said, yes. Not gonna name names, and my word is just as worthless as his, because, you know, to me that's just the classic playing online games and telling someone that's trolling you in game.
My brother works for Steam, I'm gonna get you banned.
That sort of thing. So rumors are rumors, take that with a mountain of salt, but I'm still willing to bet that it's gonna be a minute before we see a four. Like I said, Polaris may be able to afford not so great investments. I mean, look at the slingshot. But yeah, what do you guys think? More importantly, you guys like Takis? Who the hell eats that crap, dude? That shit's nasty. In fact, I'm gonna put more certainty in this statement that if you like Takis enough that it's a viable market to sell them here, you're a bad person. Anyways, guys, it's been good talking to you. Let me know what you think down in the bottom, and I'll see y'all later.